we need a mixture of lit people sitting on each side. Normally, the left side is more lit than the right side. This is where the angels be at. But y'all looking a little dry over there, so I don't know. I feel you, sis. The energy can't go low. Y'all just ate, so the energy have to go here. The jollof and chicken was the gas. So I'm going to need the fuel to go all the way to F.
Hello, hello. Checking.
It's Elijah's leg position for me. He about to sleep in the front. This is sleep in the front pose. I know that's right, Lindra.
I'm going to come on this side since she tried to play this side. I'm going to come on here.
All right. Shout out to the food team. Food and hospitality always holding it down. H.O.M. Mary. Make some noise for the H.O.M. Mary. Look at her in the back washing dishes. I know that's right, Mary. Settle in. Everyone in the back, please come towards the front. Let us settle in. Hype people only. Thank you very much. The celebrant is ready for us. Are you ready for the celebrant? Oh, I said, are you ready for the celebrant?
Make some noise.
Somebody that has been a blessing to both you and I, this church and the whole entire world. It's right. It's only right that we be on our feet. Hitting the Stevie Wonder happy birthday song. We're getting ready for our celebrant on our feet.
And to have a world party on the day you came to be. Happy birthday to
it's
you.
It's our celebrant.
Happy
ready? I see you guys are looking up. She feels the draw. She feels the draw. But everybody can look forward real quick. Sister Hager, we need to get a scan of the people. We need to scan the people really quick.
Oh, it's gone.
Let's see the energy level.
I didn't even begin the scan yet, please.
Because I don't think they know there's some prizes. And the prizes only go to the people with the most energy. I like that. I like that. Lady in red is giving me vibes right now. Oh, Lisa standing on chairs. Lisa not playing. Oh, wow, somebody's waving a Mac. Oh, she's sacrificing her MacBook for the cause. Wow, somebody got their own tambourine. Nothing's better than your own voice, though. Wow. Gorgeous woman coming right now. Come on, if you look to your left, you will see our mama looking at the screen as well. Let us overwhelm her with love.
Come on, make some noise for our mama.
We can't get tired. Come on, let's hear it.
Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya.
Come on, put your hands together. Let's go.
David Woods.
us. Thank you all for joining us. But before we officially start our party, we want to start off with a prayer. If Brother Ja is around. If not, I'm going to open for you. Here he comes. Put your hands together as Brother Ja comes to open us out.
Amen. Are you excited for today? Amen, amen, amen. Before we get started, just want to open up a prayer. Amen. Amen. Let us just bow our heads. Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for such a day, for such a wondrous, glorious, eventful, and celebratory day, O Lord. Father, as we come here in your presence, O Lord, we pray, Lord, that the spirit of joy and celebration would just reign all over this place in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord. Father, we pray that, Lord, this would be a memorable day for our mama in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that everything that's connected to this program, O Lord, Father, it will glorify you in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord. Let the heavens be open over this service right here in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord. We thank you. We bless you. We soak everything that's connected to this in the blood of Jesus Christ. And we say thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
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 Amen. So at this time, I heard that the choir has prepared a very beautiful ministration for our prophetess. So we will call upon our very own KFT anointed choir. That's right. You can make some noise. You can encourage them as they're coming up. Say you didn't encourage them enough, so they're thinking about it. Do you want to hear a ministration from the choir? That was a little weak. I said, do you want to hear a ministration from the choir? I guess. But before they come, one more time, I don't know if you guys heard earlier. My mama got a Tesla! Okay, so the choir is working on it. So we're going to start off with an activity. And please, let's take these activities serious because there's prizes behind each activity. So the violence will take the prize by what? So those are the only rules. The violence take it by force. So we have our first activity.
The first game of the evening is called This or That. So in this game, there will be on the screen two options. One of them, if you think or you believe that prophetess would choose the first one that comes on the screen, then you stand. If you think it would be the second one, then you sit. And then our lovely prophetess, you would reveal the answer at the end of every one. Somebody say this or that. Take your right hand, say this or that. Let's see. Our first one, media team. So our prophetess, would she rather have a Snapple apple or a cranberry? If you think it's don't come and chew me. If you think it's Snapple apple, you stand. If you think it's cranberry, you have a seat. Prophetess, scan your church members. They think they know you. They think they know you. Somebody boldly stood up, said Snapple apple. And media team, we can have music in the background, please. All right, prophetess, reveal our answer.
And the answer is water. It is water. Hallelujah.
Prophetess said, everybody that stood up and sat with boldness, you all are wrong. Next one. Next slide.
Media, scroll.
Would our prophetess rather have ice cream or red velvet cheesecake? Somebody said water. ice cream or red velvet cheesecake? Okay, we have a lot of ice creams. Drum roll, please.
Chocolate. Praise the Lord.
Chocolate. Somebody's given a tip. They said with this one, you gotta think outside the box. Next one, media team, please. Somebody say next one. Would prophetess rather Ghana gospel or Nigerian gospel? Ghana gospel. If you think it's Ghana, somebody say yeah, 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 yeah. If you think it's Nigerian gospel, say Omo Naija. Prophetess Nigeria.
We're changing the name of the game to this, that, or the other one. Because
so this, that, or outside the box. No, this one is testing the prophetic senses of the members, you know. Because anybody want to give us a quick hymn? Who's a hymn head here? You want to give us a blessed assurance?
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine, and a salvation purchased of love, born of the Spirit.
This is my story. This is my song. Come on, church.
Faith in my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Faith in my Savior all the day long.
I remember one time we were on the mountains last year and prophetess brought up this hymn. What was it? We are marching to Zion. And we were all praying and we all low-key stopped in the spirit like, we do not know this song. And prophetess kept singing it with boldness and we just picked it up and continued on in the third heaven. So it's true, prophetess does love hymns. Amen. Next one, please. Straight wig or curse. They didn't let me finish, they said Bob. Somebody said braids. Everybody don't even know what to do with this.
Well, I like curly wigs.
Everybody's like, I knew it. Meanwhile, next. Lip gloss or lipstick? And if it's lip gloss, you have to stand up now.
And the answer is a lip gloss.
So many times. Now, is prophetess more of a spontaneous person or planned to perfection? Event scene, which one is it? Hey.
It is spontaneously planned to perfection.
Spontaneous, that's perfectly put. Spontaneously planned to perfection. Amen. When the Holy Ghost say it, then you do it well with excellence. Next. Now, would she rather stay home or go out? Stand up if you think it's stay home. Sit down if you think it's go out.
She stay home.
Everybody's confused, low-key.
Well, I would rather stay outside of my house.
Which is low-key outside. Somebody say, we outside.
We outside.
Amen. And that is a testament of God's faithfulness. Whenever we say we outside, it's not just because. It's because the devil thought. The devil thought. Somebody say, the devil thought.
The devil thought.
But we outside. That stupid devil.
Okay, I'll do it. Okay.
Next one. Online shopping or in person?
Online.
Stand up if you think it's online. Sit down if you think it's in person. This one, if I can even stand on the altar for online, I will.
I'm an online shopper. I went to Target yesterday. They didn't know how to put the thing in the machine.
Next one. Watch it or Jalal. Salad. Salad, green juice.
Green jalap. Jalap for sure.
Next. Heels or flat? Now, heels, ladies, stand up. And if you think it's flat, stay seated.
Well, I'm a midget, so I always have to have my heel.
Wait, how y'all sitting down? Our mama be 8 months pregnant in 8-inch stilettos. You guys didn't peep in one?
That are not comfortable, by the way. That are not comfortable. Oh, side note, prophetess. When I came to this ministry, you taught me how, and you taught most of us, how to stay on point with the dressing. Even if my leg is cramping, I will come and stand up here with my broken foot in a heel. Because I cannot come crazy. Next one. Before we go to this game, prophetess, I actually got a notification on my phone. And we have a call for you. And the call is coming from a special place. Media team, can we answer it? I'm not sure. You know, sometimes the service acts up in here, but they're trying to get you. They told me that they need to get this information to you. So, media team, you can play it. Let's answer the call. Come on, make some noise. Those kind of phone calls, you don't get them easily. Somebody say, shout out to Minister Judy Kay. Prophetess, we all over the globe, love and adore you. Next game, media team. Make some noise for our prophetess. Make some noise if she's ever been a blessing to you. Make some noise if she's impacted your life. Make some noise if you will never be the same. Make some noise if this year Think Pink, we going up. We are turning up. We are going to massacre the Stamford, Connecticut. Hallelujah. We're going to paint the town pink. All right, media team. Our next game, who knows Prophetess best? So this is how it's going to go, right? If you know the answer, you stand up. The first three people to stand up, we bring the mic to you, and then Prophetess will reveal who is correct or if everyone's correct, and then a winner will be announced at the end. So then events team, we can tally who is getting the most points. So get your stance ready. All right, media team. What did she major in? 1, 2, 3. So it's 1, 2, 3.
Biology.
You have biology.
Psychology.
Psychology.
All right. Prophetess.
I have a bachelor's in biology and sociology. Mm. And I have a master's in psychology.
So who do you want to give it to? That one is a warm-up. What was her side hustle in college? 1, 2. Fiona. So we have our sister in the back. I saw Chinelo next, and then Sister Fiona.
Prophetess did hair. She did weaves and braids, I think.
Hair, weaves, and braids.
Braiding hair.
Braiding hair.
That was a specialty.
And we have a special answer here, please.
Deliverance in the dorm room.
Deliverance in the dorm rooms. All right, Prophetess, can you reveal to us what your side hustle in college was?
I was doing all types of hair and delivering for.
All types of hair. A deliverance hair minister of the gospel. Meanwhile, some of us in college, we couldn't feel well. Next question, please. How much did she save up in college doing hair? 1. I seen Sister Stavencia Illumide, and I didn't see the third person. It's true. Sister needs two.
I think it was 20,000.
It was 21,000.
Meanwhile, Illumide is at an auction. All right, Prophetess.
Well, at the end, it was 20K.
And who can tell us bonus? What did she use the 20K for? Our lady in red. Hey!
Yeah, she gave it to ministry. She gave it to ministry.
That's a bit vague. She gave it to ministry. Hey, go on your side.
So it was for merch for her church.
Mm-hmm.
They bought clothes with it,
no? Somebody in the back. Rosé in the back. Rosé, make some noise for Rosé. Let's give it to our sister Rose. Merch.
She sowed a seed into her marriage.
Zing, 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 zing.
Yes, I sowed a seed into my marriage, but the $1,000 that I had is what we bought merch for.
Next question. How many siblings does she have? 1. Yeah, Franca, Stavencia. But I saw Stavencia first. Six. Franca, shout it out loud. Six. Stand up. You can stand up. 1 second. Sis, go first. There's six. They are giving us open-ended.
Lala's iPad. I'm just going to bring it to you, okay? Lala's iPad.
She has six, including her is seven.
So, prophetess, can you reveal how many siblings do you have?
I have six siblings.
Six siblings. Give it up
including
for yourself.
Including me is seven of us.
Coming to chew me. Did I say you were wrong? Next question. What is the name of the college she attended? I saw Illumide, Fiona. Who's that? It's Desiree that stood up, but she's still thinking. All right, Illumide, what college?
Buffalo University.
Buffalo University, okay.
Is it DUville, I think?
Wow, DUville. Okay, and Fiona.
So for her bachelor, she went to Buff State.
Oh, wow.
And then for her master, she went to DUville.
We can't hear you.
For her bachelor, she went to Buff State. And then for her master, she went to DUville.
We want to thank the lawyer for doing the research. Give it up for Fiona.
Well, my bachelor's, I did half at Buffalo State College, and I did the other half at DUville College, and I did my master's at Madai College.
Wow, somebody say Madai. You never went there. Next one. What year did Ethel meet Apostle? Illumide, Esther.
Huh?
Wait. Okay, please, because I'm about to get up. Okay, they said the question is vague. What year did Ethel meet Apostle?
Elmo?
For the second time. You guys are about to beat me up. Meanwhile, you're still sitting down. Illumide, and then Sister Esther.
2005.
Wow.
It's Sister the confidence.
Esther. Sister Esther. The second time, Sister Esther.
The second time.
Hey, Esther, the answer is changing.
2006.
And who's the third person? Oh, sis in the back. So we have 2005. Esther, you said 2006. Let me take a watermelon while I'm here.
2008.
We have 2008.
Prophetess. Apostle and I first met in 1998.
We wasn't even born.
Some of you were in the womb. Sleeping in the womb. That I said it for. Hey, people are many. I said it.
Yeah. It was 1998, and then we reconvened again in 2008. And then we reconvened again in 2014.
Somebody say reconvene. It's important, all right? So all hope is not lost. You can reconvene, okay? Yeah. Next question. Word of the day, reconvene, okay? Who is your favorite gospel artist? Says Bria.
Judy K.
You have Judy K. Anybody have another answer? Oh, wow. All right. They gently sat down. Prophetess, is it?
Hey, just my favorite gospel artist is KFT Choir.
Praise Him. Hallelujah. KFT Choir, I hope you remember that one on the hard days. You hear it, all right? The days things are not going well, listen to it. Next one. What is your favorite color? One. A lot of people are not sure. Sister Brittany, Sis Chloe. All right, go ahead, Sis Chloe.
Her favorite color is pink.
Her favorite color is pink, Sis Brittany.
White and gold, please.
White and gold. Anyone else? Oh, who? Oh. Purple. Prophetess.
My favorite colors are white and gold.
Give it up for Brittany. Spot on. Next. What was or is her dream job? We have Chinelo. Oh, Steph, Chinelo, and Amanda.
Her dream job was to be a doctor. Her dream job is to be a spiritual doctor.
To be a demon-busting medical doctor.
Can you hear me? Okay. I believe she wanted to be a cardiovascular surgeon. So heart surgery or a neurosurgeon.
All right, Prophetess, can you reveal it to us?
Well, Amanda is correct.
All right. Prophetess, media team is whispering to me that we have another incoming video call. Media team, we are ready for you. Somebody say ring, ring.
Hey, beautiful angel, happy birthday to you. I need to join the choir. Prophetess Leslie, what a blessing. What a massive blessing you are to our world. On this day, we all rise up and we call you blessed. Thank you for being such a blessing to us. Thank you for being a great wife and a great mother, an award-winning woman of God. Your path shines brighter and brighter and brighter. The longer you live, the brighter you will shine. I love you so much. The bishop, our children and grandchildren, and the entire ministry send you our love. Please enjoy your day. It is yours. And it's going to only get better. I am Funke Felix Adejo.
Somebody stand up and give it up. Stand on your feet. Come on. Our prophetess is globally, internationally, locally, leaving her footprint everywhere and impacting people's lives. Just to see Mama Funke talk about our prophetess in this way. That alone is an amazing thing. One day you're in your bedroom writing on your notebook that you want to see such a woman of God in your midst. The next day she's your mama in the spirit and she's sending you a birthday video. This can only be. Amen. Come on, give a clap offering unto the Lord. Now at this time, prophetess, we've had so many funny, serious moments, some crying. Some we didn't think we survived. Some were so funny. We just enjoy your presence, all of us here. But we have a few people that do want to share our stories out loud with you. Some will make us laugh. Some will make us cry. But we just want to let Prophetess know the moments we've had with her that we can never forget. So to start it off, we're going to call our sister Mary, our brother Michael Merku, and our sister Head Usher. So give a clap offering unto Sis Mary, Michael Merku, and Head Usher. Amen. You guys can do better than that. And I know Head Usher probably just went outside to get Mike, but Mary.
Prophetess was about three, four years ago when we went to London for the first time. And as you guys know, women and our issues and tissues, we had a little, you know, friction between some of our sisters, and here comes a rebuke. That was the first time I had gotten a rebuke from First Lady. So at night, we were ready to go skate in, go have dinner, have fun in London. And then
Mary scooped apart. So this is what happened, right? We was all fighting in where we were, I don't even know. And Brother Mike, this is a London story. And Brother Mike was trying to calm everybody down. So that same day, Apostle and Prophetess was arriving in London. So we all trying to calm down so that they don't sense that nothing is going up. So they come and visit us where we are. And Mike's like, everybody calm down, calm down. You guys are doing too much. And so we all calm down. And then Prophetess and Apostle arrive in their car. And we all, oh, Apostle, Prophetess in the car, just gasping, whatever. And, you know, first they say how, Apostle say how. We all think that they didn't see nothing. So we, later on that night, get dressed, thinking we about to hit the town, go for ice cream, do all of that. And we did. Mary, continue the story. Me and Mary were sitting in the ice cream shop when...
when we received a text from our WhatsApp group that everybody, I need you guys here right now, everybody. So we're wondering what's the issue, what's the problem, because we thought we're good. And come right now. And my sis here went to Primark with a bunch of bags behind her back. She was trying to hide it when she got to the hotel lobby. So we're there with our Apostle, Prophetess, and the whole group in the circle, like we're having a family meeting. And at that moment, I really wanted to disappear. Like, it was scary. That was the first time I saw First Lady really, like. And she was going around and giving to everybody, rebuking everybody. So I'm wondering, what has this got to do with me? Because I thought, me, I wasn't part of it. But when it got to me, and you, Mary, and you, Nonchala, nothing. Nothing bothers you in this life. She really gave it to me. Like, I had to rethink about my life. Like, wow, it's true. Like, she's right.
It's true.
And then, Head of Show was sitting right next to me. You, Esther. Sitting there like Egyptian mamba. That day, all I want to say that we really got rebuked. Like, we had to recheck our lives. Go home and think. Like, think about your life. Yeah, like, and then the next day was France, Paris. And my sis here, she really got it that day. You should have seen her outfit. I don't know if media. It was raining. She was wearing her sandals and socks. Amen.
It's really cool. So that day, like Mary said, we never got rebuked like that before. That rebuke, that was a London special rebuke. And I could not feel well. I want you guys to know, before rebuke come, my wig go all the way right here. I cannot. So the next day, we were supposed to go to Paris, and it was supposed to be a family trip, all nice vibes. It was not like that for me. I ended up wearing slides like this. Even the slides were supposed to be cute, and I had some long slides up to right here. Some white pants, jean jacket. My outfit just didn't go well. My wig did not go well. Everything, I was crying, it was done. Then we all had to take pictures. Dang, I wish I would have sent it. We all had to take pictures as a group. Everybody was cool, laughing, kiki, only me. That's it, this is the group. This is me trying to take the picture. Because I was so sick, and it was getting worse. So I want you guys, please stand on your feet, and God bless Apostle. Because Apostle been coming through for the crew since 1996. Anytime we get in maybe soon, let me not look at Apostle because I'm about to cry. Apostle really been there for us. I'm getting emotional. Let me calm down. Apostle really has been there for us. I don't think you get it. Anytime the rebuke come and our flesh is in the way and we can't take it, Apostle's always there in the background to reel us back in because the enemy will really be trying to take us out. But Apostle that day came to me on the side and he was like, it's okay. She's your mother. She will not disown you. You want her to disown you? So smile and go and take the picture with her. And this me. She mad at me. I don't think she's going to talk to me. So Apostle literally forced my hair in the picture, and this Prophetess. No, I'm going to send the picture. She did not do nothing to her face, nothing to her body. Even in the picture, you can see the divide. It just looks sick in the picture. And we just both standing there like this. And me too, I'm standing there like this. No smile came out of my face. And Prophetess was like. And that was it. And I took my sick face back to London that night from Paris. Could not enjoy that trip, but it's really cool. At the end, the real thing of this whole story is that Prophetess has really trained us to not, how do I say this, to be able to take things and be able to move quickly with it. Like you can testify even in your workplaces or even in your friend groups. When someone says something to you, often we dwell on it too long. We let it offend us. We overanalyze it. We think about it. We change who we are. It slows us down. Sometimes it doesn't even allow us to do the work of God correctly. But Prophetess has taught us through many rebukes that you take it, you work on it, you keep on moving. There's nobody else. One thing that I've learned is the Lord rebukes those he loves. The moment I really caught that, I'm training myself and I'm still am to never be offended. Like you take it like, oh wow, God, thank you for seeing me enough to really tell me about myself. Because some people would just keep on going. Nobody's telling you about yourself. You just keep on doing damage blindly. But thank God for a mother like Prophetess that will tell us about ourselves and not be amused by the feedback that we give to change who she is. But just God bless you, Prophetess. Amen. And now, second story, we will call Brother Ja and Sister Deb. Amen. Give it up for Brother Ja and Sister Deb. Come on, give it up. You can do better. Pastor, you know, Mike needs time to process.
Oh, Jesus. So hello everybody. Oh man, so a wild story. I want to take it back. Yeah, way back, maybe about 4 years ago, 2018, September to be exact, a week before the men's wedding. And my wife and I, it wasn't my wife back then, she was my shorty, my girlfriend. Yeah, we had some smoke with each other back around that time. And
so a week before, 6 days before, 6 days to be exact, before the men's wedding, me and Brother Jolly broke up because he had, you know, some choice words for me. So I was like, all right, you know what? I'm coming out of this relationship. I don't want to be with you anymore. And vice versa, he felt the same way. So after Brother Prince and Sister Juliet got married, we had to change into our second outfits. So because I knew we had broken up, I thought that, you know, I could meet somebody, you know. And you know how girls, how we think, you know, can make him feel sick, you know, that he let me go for the past 6 days, didn't call, didn't text, didn't do nothing. Cool. So I told... I told the lady who designed my dress to, you know, take it in a couple of inches. And the slit was here, and I asked her to bring it up a couple of inches. Everybody was going to get changed, and I was like, man, Apostle and First Lady are still here. So I was like, okay, let me just out myself. So I went to Apostle and I went to First Lady, and I said, Apostle, First Lady. And then Pastor's like, Depstar. And I said, Apostle, so here's the thing. We have to change into our second outfit. So I just wanted to let you know the second outfit's a little bit inappropriate. I didn't know you guys would still be here. And First Lady looked at me like, what's wrong with the outfit? And I said, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just a little bit tight and the slit is high. And she said, how high? And I said, you know, it's like... So then basically I ended up telling them that me and Ja broke up and, you know, we weren't feeling well. So I really planned to make him sick. And So first lady said, all right, go get changed. So I went to get changed, and oh, I made Brother Charlie sick.
Let me stop it right there. First of all, wasn't nobody sick. Second of all, nah, don't let Andrea, nah, because Andrea will, she'll expose you, please. Yeah, but, Let me tell you what she was trying to do the whole time. So, like that whole time, right? Let me tell you how. Alright, she was trying to make me sick. But let me tell you the way that she was trying to make me sick, right? I was just like looking at this, I'm like, nah, this girl out here being mad childish with it. So she was like kind of fake flirting with the other groomsmen a little bit, digging her hands in the chips and all that stuff. I'm like, hey, this girl really trying to like have me throw some hands out here, like. But long story short, but even after all that, so after Deb told Prophetess and Apostle that, Prophetess pulled us both to the side. She was like, oh, what's going on with y'all? So I was just like, we're not together no more. So she was like, oh, do you love her? I'm like, yeah, I do. And then she was like, oh, yeah, I can tell because you sound like you was about to fight me when you said it. And then after that, she asked Deb the same question. And then, like, in that same moment, you know, she just gave us, like, words of wisdom, you know, just on how to, like, make the relationship better. And just told us that, you know, this is stuff that we're praying for, so we can't, like, let the littlest things separate us and cause whatever we was fighting for to go to waste. So we better, we better get it together and get it right and figure it out. And something that she always do is that, you know, one thing I noticed about Prophetess is that she don't want people around her always beefing. Like, she will make you make up. So right there, she made us made up. And I wish I sent the pictures to the media so y'all could see how high her slip was and the pictures that we took after that. What do you want?
It's okay. But in all, one thing that I know in 2019, you know, we were hitting some, you know, frictions with getting married. And one thing I told Apostle and First Lady, I said, me and, you know, Jalik, we're going to go to Las Vegas and just elope. So I had asked her, if it would be accepted in the church. And she said, no, like, you would have to start the church all over, like, everything, the fasting. So she said that there's honor in waiting and honor in getting all the family, you know, on board to accept the marriage. And the reason why I'm saying this is because Apostle and First Lady, they really go beyond what pastors do. They go beyond what even some of our parents would do, some of our siblings. You know, if it wasn't for Apostle and First Lady, we literally wouldn't have had a wedding. We literally, no engagement, no nothing. You know, with, you know, our wedding, Prophetess and Apostle, they took it personal, like personal. So if you all guys can stand up for me and just thank them. Thank them for me, please. Because sometimes, you know, in so many situations, you can't appreciate the ones that love you the most. Well, they see other sides of you. But during COVID, when people were banging pots for the medical field, like in the heart of COVID, so many people canceled their weddings. Literally, Prophetess was like, we gotta have this wedding. And it was so cold. Like, she got everybody in the church to put their hands in a plow. Some people didn't even know our names. But, you know, Apostle and Prophetess, we thank you for your love towards us, for the church. We really wouldn't be here without you. And we love you from our heart. And we thank you for your heart of service towards us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen, Sis Gladys. Let's encourage her as she comes quickly. She's already crying as she comes up here, guys. Oh, Gladys.
on my own tissue. So Tracy, can you show the picture, please? Can you show the picture? So I remember the first time I met Apostle and Prophetess. It was in their old apartment. This is the first time Mary was cooking for them with Sandra. And I was just some, I don't know. I was just some ratchet, I guess, girl up in their house. I was really comfortable, but I think it's because my spirit picked up that I was home. And First Lady was so nice. And coming to the church, I never noticed that was me in the background with First Lady. And to see my life. You know, you've made my smile your smile. You've made my tears your tears. You've made my shortcomings your assignment. And I don't know what kind of favor located me. But you're really one of a kind. I'm the type of person, if I like you, I really like you. If I don't like you, well, that's that. But First Lady, you are someone who everyone deserves you in their life. Apostle, I have to mention you because I can't talk about First Lady without talking about you either. You remember one time I was studying for an exam. Apostle literally said, "Don't me for 2 hours." And he did not want to stop until I understood what I was talking about. So compliments. Compliments. For loving someone like me. And showing that God loves me too, because I really believe the love of God for me through you. So I really appreciate you, and I gotta go.
Amen. Gladys is a representative of us all and how Apostle and Prophetess have impacted our lives. So God bless you, Apostle and Prophetess. And our last one, we have Brother Matthew. Let's encourage him as he comes.
I got a couple stories. I'll keep it short. So, first thing is, you know, Prophetess, I don't know if you guys know, but, you know, she sees things real time. Like, I'm talking real time, like, as it's happening. So, like, literally as it's happening, as I'm moving, she knows exactly what I'm doing. So, it was one story. I'll just be transparent. I was about to, you know, do a frat, going to a frat. I was in the city, making my moves, doing whatever for the frat. I look at my phone. Matthew, where are you? I'm like, I'm in the city. I'm at work. And then she's like, I hope you're not pledging. And right then and there, and I was literally in the moment, just doing everything for that particular frat. And right then and there, she texts me in that particular moment, like, I hope you're not pledged. So I'm like, how do you know? So in that moment, I'm just like, I dropped everything before I even got through the process, got to Syracuse, got through everything, and it was just dead from there. Another thing was, you know, I was, one time I'm sitting with a girl. She's like, where are you? I'm supposed to be in Virginia. I was supposed to be in Syracuse at the time. She says, where are you? She called me, her and Apostle, at the same time. They're like, okay. Okay. I'm in Syracuse. They said, no, you're not. They said, no, you're not. Meanwhile, nobody knew where I was for a whole year. Like, I didn't reach out to nobody for a whole year. Nobody had any tracks on me, nothing. She just knew where I was in the spirit. Like, she literally walks with me in the spirit. She tarries for me in the spirit. She does everything with me in the spirit. She makes sure I'm safe in the spirit. Everything that she does is for her little brother. And I just, yeah, she loves me, even though she don't show it sometimes. She literally loves me on another level. And I just, like, she showed enough love to me to last a lifetime. And I told her this morning, like, I don't need anything else from her. Like, now is just whatever I could do for her, whatever God leads me to do for her. I always say that my purpose in life is to protect her. My purpose in life is to be her second or third ear. Anything that she doesn't know, I got to let her know. Anything that she doesn't see, I got to let her see. You know what I mean? So my last few things is coming into Christ. And y'all know this story. So basically, I got jumped by like 8 guys. 2 of them pulled out a gun on me in a nail salon and told me to come out just so I could get shot, apparently. So I got back home and I got routed up, called a couple guys, like, yeah, we about to go back out, we about to do this, we about to do that. And then my sister heard. So her and Apostle came from Stratford, Connecticut, all the way to Brooklyn within an hour. It took like 2 hours to get to Brooklyn. They got there within 30 minutes. I don't know how they got there so quick, but they got there. So they came and then they was like, you know, like, it's over. Like, we're moving you out. Like, we're moving out to Connecticut. You're not having that. I was supposed to go to Jamaica in 2-3 days. I'm like, nah, I'm not going with y'all. I'm not going with y'all. I'm not going with y'all. I'm not going with y'all at all. They was like, nah, you coming. You coming. You coming. You coming. You coming. So it's all of that that led until this particular day. Like, this particular day. And lastly, you know, being familiar, you know, it wasn't a good thing for me. So when she would declare... when she would declare some things or be like, you know, this will happen if you go to Jamaica, I didn't pay attention to it. So she told me, if you go to Jamaica within 2-3 days, the same guys will find you, then you'll get shot. So I'm like, yo, you be trying to scare me with everything. This is how I'm talking to her at the time. Like, you be trying to scare me with everything. Like, are you getting me upset, whatever. So fast forward, Prophet Prempe comes, and then he's like, I don't know if you guys remember when he came for that. He said it was 3 days left until you died, until you got shot. And it was the same word that Prophetess declared like 2-3 months back. So I just got to stand here and say, if it not for my sister, if not for Prophet, if not for Apostle, I would not be here. I would not be alive. I would not be standing here. And thank you for everything you do for the ministry. Thank you for everything you do for your family, for our family, for everyone around you. She has a pure heart. Like, she literally has a pure heart. Sometimes she could just... like, it's unexplainable. It's unexplainable. I just pray that, I think the Bible says, delight your heart in the Lord, and he will grant you your heart's desire. So I pray that everything that you desire from this day on, that he will not leave you astray, that he will just provide you with every single thing that you want in this lifetime. I love you so, so much. I love you so much.
All right, fam. We are nearing the end. We have just a few more surprises. One more speaker, and then media team, we have another call, so get that ready. Amen.
Hallelujah. My song is encouragement word. Ma bo wudin na ma freo. Inti mi be nya kukudro. Enche ben kuma nye nifa. Wudie pin kwa weni mwa. Misi men paba. Fisa mi na mi bo we chiri domwe. Sanye mi di mo se china. Sara na me di we chida. Mirinya wo. Mirin pa wa. Makame untam se. Mia na mi si me buwa wo. Enunti me mpa ba. Fisa mi na mi bo we chiri domwe. Sanye mi di debo rechina. Sara na me di wechida. This song, when I was taking bath this morning, I was praying.
and the Lord give it to me, because since yesterday, the Lord dropped prophetess into my heart. So I was, you know, I said, I'm not going to cook today. I'm not going to do anything, especially Sunday. I'm bringing both fruit and, you know, pie. But I decide not to do anything and thanking God. And the Lord give me two words for you. One is Psalm 124.
If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say, if the Lord had not been on our side when people attacked us, they would have swallowed us alive when their anger flared against us. The flood would have engulfed us. The torrent would have swept over us. The raging waters would have swept us away. Praise be to the Lord who has not let us be torn by their teeth. We have escaped like a bird from the fowler's snare. The snare has been broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and the earth.
And one word is
Exodus 14:13, New King James Version. And Moses said to the people, do not be afraid, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again, no more forever.
Amen. Let's put our hands together. All right, media team, we can play our last phone call.
Day to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear prophetess, happy birthday to you. May you live a very long and satisfied life. May God continue to use you globally. We can't wait for you to get to Kenya. Oh, we are looking forward. May God increase your years. May your days be just amazing on this earth as you affect generations after you. Keep going, prophetess. Enjoy this day and enjoy many more to come. Love you. Mwah, mwah, mwah. All the way from Kenya.
Happy birthday, prophetess, from KOTNC.
On the 17th of July, my singer gave to us
Prophetess Leslie. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya.
Prophetess Leslie, on behalf of KFT North Carolina, we want to wish you a happy birthday. We want to say we love you so much. Thank you for being a mother to us. We always feel your love, your compassion that you show towards us. We can't wait to see you here in North Carolina. We wish that on this day you have an excellent day, you have a joyous day. We pray that may you encounter more of God's love and favor on your life. On behalf of KFT North Carolina, we say
happy birthday.
Glorious happy birthday, First Lady. On behalf of KMT DMV, we say
happy birthday, First Lady. We love you. God bless you.
It's your birthday, yes, sir.
It's a very, very happy and a joyous day because my wife is turning another year. I want to celebrate our First Lady, the prophetess of this house, the mother of all my children, the love of my life, the blessing of my life. She is the blessing that God gave me, and I want to celebrate you on this special day. I understand and I know how important birthdays are to you, and I just want to also show my love in this manner by celebrating you publicly. I just want you to know that I love you, I care for you, I pray for you on such a day like this, that the Lord will give you long life, 120 years, and good health, with joy, peace, love, and prosperity. I'm speaking prophetically. May you live that long. May the Lord cause all your enemies to bow before you, just like he did for Joseph. I pray that the grace that was upon Mary to be highly favored, may that grace come upon you on such a day like this. May the Lord increase your influence worldwide. May he bless your life in every dimension. May your children be blessed. May the Lord answer every prayer on your heart in Jesus' name. My love, I love you. You are the best thing that has ever happened to me, and I thank God for your life in Jesus' name. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Amen. Let us all be upstanding. Yes, making some noise for the birthday lady of the hour, of the day, of the month. You can do better than that. Come on, a violent shout. A violent shout. A violent shout. At this time, we want to cut the cake. And we will call on Apostle and Prophetess Tiffany to cut the cake with our birthday celebrant. Amen. Amen.
Easy concepts.
Why can't you do? What won't you do? Nothing impossible. Nothing impossible.
Let's encourage the birthday girl as she comes.
What can't you do?
Still mothering. What you do? Even on her birthday, nothing still making it do what it gotta do.
With our God. You do not lie, you do not fail. What is hard for you to do, it doesn't exist.
Amen.
It's gonna ever, ever exist.
Amen. What a beautiful cake.
You do not lie, you do not fail. What
Let's stretch forth our hands. Father, we bless these cakes. Let it be prophetic that everyone that tastes of this will also be impacted with the grace that is working in your daughter's life. In Jesus' name, we sanctify this cake with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 So we would like to cut the cake. All right. Amen. As we cut this cake, we celebrate our First Lady, our prophetess, our mother, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ooh, more cakes to cut. Let's go. All right, Danny, be careful. Be careful. There's more cakes. In the name of the Father. All right. Yay. Amen. Amen. God bless all of you for celebrating. Our First Lady, come on, give the Lord a shout. Amen.
Amen. And to close us, we'll have our prophetess Tiffany close us out in prayer for our mama. Amen.
Everybody bow your heads. I don't know what to say outside of what's been said because it's already done. So I just say the prayer for you is it. Is finished. It is finished. It is finished. And she declared a word that what takes people 10 years would take her a month. But I just declare what takes people 10 years will take her a week or a day. And I pray that the anointing on her life will make her easily slide in and out of nations without her and Apostle being noticed. I pray that the anointing on their life will be so powerful that as soon as they walk past you, just the shadow will heal you. I pray that the anointing on their life is so powerful that people can't stand them but can't help but to bless them and favor them, that their names go in rooms that their feet may not ever touch, that anytime somebody tries to tarnish their name, favor speaks on their behalf. And we just declare that God has remembered her, God has remembered him, God has remembered the family. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for increase. We thank you for grace. We thank you for double mercy. We thank you for favor. We thank you for favor. And we thank you for favor. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless each and every one of you for coming and celebrating our mother. She loves us all and she appreciates it. We appreciate it. God bless you all. You can give a clap offering for yourself. Amen. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen. One more time, make some noise for the birthday girl.
Again, I just want to thank you all. God bless you. May the Lord cause you to be celebrated all year long. In Jesus' name, amen.
And if you brought any special gift for Prophetess, please see Sister Ama or anyone on the protocol team. Please make sure that your name is specified on the gift. Amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Combination Worldwide,
it's our 6th year
anniversary. God has been faithful.
It's been 6 years of God's grace,
authentic word,
divine favor,
deliverance,
and divine testimony.
Somebody say, it's God's grace.
Say, it is God's grace.
Say, it is God's grace.
Everything about our lives is about God's grace.
For by grace
are you saved.
Any man that God is moving through them will never take credit, because they know themselves that what God is doing, they cannot do it.
Yes, Holy Ghost. Yes, Holy Ghost. Have your way. I came to prophesy to you today that your end shall be greater. That a time is coming where the same family members that keep on mocking you, yes, you better receive that, that keep mocking you for driving 2 and 3 hours to come and seek the face of God, much like Joseph, they will come and bow. They will come and bow.
One thing that I want you to understand, that everything that is happening here, it is not any man's doing. It is the Holy Ghost. It is the power of God in action. It is the grace of God that is moving.
Get ready for a higher dimension. Get ready for a new level. Get ready to see the impossible made possible.
It's nothing like you've ever seen before. Your life will never be the same. Come join us as we celebrate the goodness. July 21st and 24th in Darien, Connecticut.
KFT, we're different. Happy anniversary.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Combination Worldwide,
it's our 6th year
anniversary. God has been faithful. It's been 6 years of God's grace, authentic word, divine favor, deliverance, and divine testimony.
Somebody say, it's God's grace. Say, it is God's grace. Say, it is God's grace.
Everything about our lives is about God's grace.
For by grace are you saved.
Any man that God is moving through them will never take credit because they know themselves that what God is doing, they cannot do it.
Yes, Holy Ghost. Yes, Holy Ghost. Have your way. I came to prophesy to you today that your end shall be greater. That a time is coming where the same family members that keep on mocking you. Yes. Receive that. That keep mocking you for driving 2 and 3 hours to come and seek the face of God. Much like Joseph, they will come and bow. They will come and bow.
One thing that I want you to understand, that everything that is happening here, it is not in.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. This is Apostle Dominic here.
And Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries.
We are excited that our 6-year anniversary is coming up this coming Thursday, the 21st to the 24th. And we would like to invite you. Tell them a little bit more about the anniversary.
4 days of a Holy Ghost pandemonium. We invite you for our 6-year anniversary. God has been so good to us. We have entered our 6th year, and we want to invite you and every guest that you have to come and join us. And where will it be taking place?
It will be in our new location in Darien, 65 Tokeneke Road, right about 2 minutes from Stanford. So we are in the same neighborhood.
Yes.
So come, listen, it's a new place. It's AC here, so come.
As Apostle said, you've heard the news. We've bought a new place by the grace of God, and we want to invite you here. We have enough room for everyone, so please come. We have some special guests, and we want to invite you to come and celebrate with us.
Yes, all the virtual members, we're expecting to see you.
Yes.
Anyone that is connected to this ministry, please come and let us thank God. God has been good for the last 6 years. And if this ministry has been a blessing to you, come and let's celebrate God together. God bless you.
And again, this is Apostle Dominic and Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries, where we manifest the kingdom of God on earth. See you.
Amen. God bless. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. This is Apostle Dominic here.
And Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries.
We are excited that our 6-year anniversary is coming up this coming Thursday, the 21st to the 24th. And we would like to invite you. Tell them a little bit more about the anniversary.
4 days of a Holy Ghost pandemonium. We invite you for our 6-year anniversary. God has been so good to us. We have entered our 6th year, and we want to invite you and every guest that you have to come and join us. And where will it be taking place?
It will be in our new location in Darien, 65 Tokeneke Road, right about 2 minutes from Stanford. So we are in the same neighborhood.
Yes.
So come, listen, it's a new place. It's AC here, so come.
As Apostle said, you've heard the news. We've bought a new place by the grace of God, and we want to invite you here. We have enough room for everyone, so please come. We have some special guests, and we want to invite you to come and celebrate with us.
Yes. All the virtual members, we're expecting to see you.
Yes.
Anyone that is connected to this ministry, please come and let us thank God. God has been good for the last 6 years. And if this ministry has been a blessing to you, come and let's celebrate God together. God bless you.
And again, this is Apostle Dominic and Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries, where we manifest the kingdom of God on earth. See you.
Amen. God bless. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. This is Apostle Dominic here.
And Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries.
We are excited that our 6-year anniversary is coming up this coming Thursday, the 21st to the 24th. And we would like to invite you. Tell them a little bit more about the anniversary.
4 days of a Holy Ghost Pandemonium. We invite you for our 6th year anniversary. God has been so good to us. We have entered our 6th year, and we want to invite you and every guest that you have to come and join us. And where will it be taking place?
It will be in our new location in Darien, 65 Tokeneke Road, right about 2 minutes from Stanford. So we are in the same neighborhood.
Yes.
So come, listen. It's a new place. It's AC here, so come.
As Apostle said, you've heard the news. We've bought a new place by the grace of God, and we want to invite you here. We have enough room for everyone, so please come. We have some special guests, and we want to invite you to come and celebrate with us.
Yes, all the virtual members, we're expecting to see you.
Yes.
Anyone that is connected to this ministry, please come and let us thank God. God has been good for the last 6 years. And if this ministry has been a blessing to you, come and let's celebrate God together. God bless you.
And again, this is Apostle Dominic and Prophetess Leslie of Kingdom Full Tabernacle International Ministries, where we manifest the kingdom of God on earth. See you.
Amen. God bless.